What if you want to connect and manage devices that have an IP and perhaps do not have any configuration at all? Let's have a look at RoMON. Router Management Overlay Network is a MikroTik proprietary solution for device access using their MAC addresses, but it works independently from the regular MAC layer. So you could have devices with no configuration whatsoever, with neighbor discovery disabled, and you could still connect to them through RoMON. An interesting side effect is that devices themselves will not see RoMON packets using Sniffer and Torch tools. In my setup, I have daisy chained three devices. The first has a public IP that I'm going to access through Winbox, but the other two have no network configuration. By enabling RoMON, I will be able to access the third one directly without having to go from the first to second and then to third. In the middle of this daisy chain, I could have a switch that is not taking part in RoMON itself, and it should work if it allows untagged multicast traffic through. However, in some cases, some switches by other manufacturers might still drop the RoMON packets. To set this up, I will simply need to enable RoMON on all three of these devices. So let's use Winbox to connect to my public IP. And here, in fact, you can see the connect to RoMON button that we'll be using later, but this time I'll just gonna connect. Okay, so if we go under tools, we see RoMON. And here we simply need to make sure that this is checked. I had already checked it here, but I do not have it on the device that's in the middle. So let's connect to that. The way we can do it is to by first see its MAC address. I have IP neighbor discovery enabled, so I'm just gonna use IP neighbor print to see my neighbors. And here I can see the RBM33G. I'm going to copy its MAC address, and I'm going to use another one of our tools, which is tool MAC Telnet. As you know, Telnet works over IP, but we have our own solution where you can use it over a MAC address. And I'm just going to paste that. Okay. I have no password there. And now I'm going to simply enable the RoMON on it. So I'm going to go tool. As you can see, it's not enabled. So I'll set enabled to yes. And now I could use the same MAC telnet method to connect to the RB5009 and enable RoMON there. But I've already done that. So now we can already use RoMON to access any one of these devices. If I open a new Winbox, I can now click the Connect to RoMON button for using the same login credentials, same IP. And now this time, it's showing me two MAC addresses. And these are the Ethernet interfaces of the RBM33G and the 5009. I can simply select the 5009, then make sure the credentials are correct. So I had no password on it. And then simply click connect. And that's a Winbox to the RB5009. But another thing that we can do is once we connect to this RoMON agent, we can then save the devices that are seen by the RoMON agent. So here, let's make sure that the login credentials are correct for the RB5009. And I'm just gonna click the Add Set button. So now if we look at the Manage section, we can see the MAC address of our RB5009. And I can just connect to it. And that's all there is to it. You could also connect to your RoMON agent through the CLI. Or if you've already connected through SSH, you can go to the tool section for RoMON. You can read more details in our help page.